Devang Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. We have been learning the subject basic electrical engineering, and we have started the chapter electrical installation, wiring and safety, where we learn about components of low tension switch gear, where we learn about a switch fuse unit, MCB, ELCB, MCCB. Then we have discussed about types of wires and cables, then earthing and its types, safety precautions for electrical appliances, types of batteries and characteristics. Today we are going to learn about type of batteries and their characteristic and elementary calculation for energy consumption and basic power factor improvement. So let's start with the today's subject, which define as the batteries. So first we need to understand what is battery, why we are using this battery. As first we go for a basic comparison between a cell and a battery. Now here, if you start with the definition of cell, you can see here the single unit device which converts the chemical energy into electrical energy. This is defined as a cell. But what is about the battery? It's nothing but a collection of electrochemical cell which either connects in series or parallel. So in another sense, it is nothing but the array of cell which are either connected in a series or parallel. So you can see here the symbol of cell as well as the symbol of battery. So battery is nothing but the collection of cells where it has a higher capacity. So if we talk about the types of cell where we use as a dry cell, wet cell, weight cell and reverse cell and fuel cell. But in the type of the battery, we define as a primary battery and a secondary battery. As we discuss about the specification where it is light and compact, but the batteries are heavy. Same way, the power, where supply power for a short time. So cell will supply the power for a short time and battery will supply the power for a longer time. If we talk about the application of cell, where it is used in a clocks, lamp, radio, remote control devices, and those devices we are using in our daily life. But batteries that we can use in automobiles, inverter, emergency light, elevator system, the cost of cell is cheap than that of the battery, right? So here the cost of battery is costly. So if we talk about further and the definition of cell, when a current passes through an electrolyte solution, the chemical reaction occurs. That is, the electrical energy is converted into a chemical energy, and conversely, chemical energy can also be converted into a electrical energy. So this device, which is capable of carrying out this conversion, is defined as a cell. So here, cell is nothing but a conversion of one energy into another energy. So one energy we define either as a chemical energy or electrical energy, and another, that is the same, right? So here the collection of cell I can define as a battery, where the primary cell or battery is one that cannot easily be recharged after one use, hence are discarded following discharge. Most primary cell utilize electrolytes that are contained within absorbent materials or a separator. So no free or liquid electrolyte, and thus are termed as a dry cell. So in particular battery, you can here refer as all the used electrolyte materials are in a dry form. That's why this is a kind of primary cell, where in a secondary cell or battery is one that can be electrically recharged after use to their original pre-discharge condition by passing current through the circuit in the opposite direction to the current during the discharge. So following graphical evidence is this recharging process, if we can consider. So here, if we talk about operation of this battery, so here we take this electrolyte as part of the liquid, where we normally define as a secondary cell. So here, battery is one of the important element of any electrical circuit, that is in form of either cell, which is only a single cell, and the collection of cells we define as a battery as two part. One is a primary cell or a battery and a secondary cell of the battery. So if we further talk about operation of lead acyl cell, you can consider as there is a container, right? In this container there is a electrolyte which is nothing but it is H2SO4 38%, which define as a sulfuric acid, and 62% of H2O, which is a distilled water in this container. And you can see this two plates. So one plate I define as an anode plate or a positive plate, and another I define as a negative plate. So if we talk about the positive plate in this case, where anode terminal is represented as a positive terminal and the cathode terminal is represented as a negative terminal. So in between, you can connect the load here. So if I define the positive plates as anode and it is a lead peroxide, it is a lead peroxide PbO2, which is available in a dark brown form or in this color. Same with the negative plates as a cathode plate, and it is lead, only the Pb, and it is available in a gray color. So here electrolyte is nothing but used a dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4 with three parts of distilled water H2O mixed with it. So you can consider here, and the separators. So these two are the separators which are available in form of either rubber placed between main plates to avoid short circuit between anode and cathode, right? Same way container. So you can see this container is made up of either plastic, ceramic or rubber, where all this electrolyte is available. So now we are going to learn about operation of this lead acyl cell from this chemical reaction. So ultimately here we are going to convert a chemical reaction or chemical energy into electrical energy, and vice versa, from electrical energy into a chemical energy, right? So if we further talk about only the part of anode and the part of cathode, when this particular lead acyl cell are in a discharging form. So when it is in a discharging form, you can see it starts discharging when the current starts flowing from battery to external load. So here current starts flowing from battery to external load. So here it would give the energy it will provide the energy to the load, where H2SO4 is disassociated into a positive H2 and negative SO4 as ion. So during this discharging process, now current is flowing from cathode to anode. So if you remember, and if you go for a chemical action at particular terminal at anode, you can see PbO2 plus H2 plus H2SO4, this chemical reaction is now converted into PbSO4 plus 2H2O, right? This is at the anode side, and same as the cathode side, if you remember. So since this particular plate is a PbSO4 plate and this is a Pb plate, the cathode part, so at cathode, Pb plus SO4, that stands to PbSO4. Now this is a discharging process, and that is the chemical action during the discharging process of this battery, where you can see both anode and cathode, PbSO4 and water H2O, that will contain it, right? Now so this is a discharging process where the battery is going to provide the energy to the load. But what about the reverse process during the charging? Now during the charging process is completely a reverse of discharging. Now here current is flowing from anode to cathode. As such, the external voltage source is connected here. So instead of load, now I'm going to connect external battery or external voltage source to charge this battery. So during this charging process, you can see that during this charging process, a positive external voltage is applied to anode and negative voltage is applied to cathode. So current flows from anode to cathode inside the electrolyte. So during this process, what kind of chemical reaction is done, that you can see from this at anode part, PbSO4 plus SO4 plus 2H2O, that is converted into a PbO2 plus 2H2SO4. And at the cathode part, if you calculate the chemical reaction, that in form of this equation which called the PbSO4 plus H2, so here the PbSO4 plus H2 is converted into a Pb plus H2SO4. So by this way, charging and discharging are being done in this lead acid cell by during this process, where you can exactly see this. Now the discharging and charging process here is given by P PbO2 plus 2H2SO4 plus Pb. Now this is a this form is now going to be discharged, and you will get PbSO4 plus 2H2O plus PbSO4 two times, where you can check the here, where you can check here, and the charging process is from this terminal to this terminal, where that particular equation is vice versa in terms of charging and discharging. So here in a discharging form, you can see the anode plus electrolyte plus cathode, it is converted into an anode plus water plus cathode. But in a charging form, here the anode plus water plus cathode is converted into an anode plus electrolyte plus cathode. Now we further discuss about the application of this lead acid battery. It is used in automobiles for starting and lightning, for lightning on stream and diesel railway and diesel railway trains. It is also used at generating stations and substations for operation of protective devices for an emergency light, and also used at the telephone exchanges. We further talk about the charging methods of this battery. Now what way you are going to charge this batteries during the utilization process? So there are two methods normally to charge these batteries. One of the method we define as a constant voltage charging. So what it's all about, let us discuss this. So it reduces the charging time. So in this method, the charging voltage is kept constant. So here you can see the charging time. Here the charging voltage is kept constant. So I'm going to make it the charging voltage kept constant. So the charging current is high. So you can see this charging current is normally high in this particular graph. So this graph stands for the battery voltage charge current versus the charge time, where the initial moment of the charging of the current, which is normally high at the beginning, and when the battery is in discharge condition, the current is gradually dropped. So you can see here the current is gradually dropped off as the battery pick up the charge, resulting in increased back EMF. So from this, it allows cells with different capacities and at the different degree of discharge to be charged, right? So from this, you can be able to understand the large charging current at the beginning of the charge is of relatively short duration and will not harm the cell. So this particular large value of this charge current will not harm the cell. So by this way, this constant voltage charging is possible. Same way, the constant current charging also can be applied. So in this method of charging, the batteries are connected in series so as to form group of each group charges from the DC supply, the main through load rheostat. So here the extra resistance would be connected when all the cells or batteries are connected in a series. So this charging current is kept constant throughout the charging period by reducing the resistance in the circuit as the battery voltage goes up. So that can be that movement you can see here from this graph, where the y-axis stands for the battery voltage charge current with respect to charge time, where the charge current remains constant, but here the battery voltage goes from lower value to the higher value. So now this is what the battery is charged through this process, where in this method the charge current is approximately 1/8 of this ampere rating, right? So that is very important method, where normally we are using this constant current charging method, right? Now if we further discuss about some of the important terms, those are related with the battery performances. So then one of the term we define as ampere hour, that is defined as AH. So here ampere hour is also called ampere hour, and it is the unit of battery capacity that measures the amount of charge that can be available in a fully charged battery. So that will ultimately measure the amount of charge that is available in a charged battery. So it is amount of charge is what determines the amount of current that can be discharged from the battery and its discharge time. So that is the why it is also called as a charge or coulombic capacity. Now another important definition we define as a watt hour. So what is a ampere hour? Now what is a watt hour? That is defined as a Wh. So it is referred to as the energy capacity of a battery, as it more accurately determines the energy that can be stored in a battery. So that will define the energy that will be stored in a battery. So this is a watt hour, same with ampere hour, is the measures of amount of charge that is available in a charge battery, right? So these are two important performance parameters in terms of the battery. Same way, if we talk about the series connection of battery, where all these batteries are connected in series with each other, so all V1, V2, V3 and V4, all these batteries are connected in a series, and that giving the energy to this particular load. So in this terms, if we are looking for the equation of VL, and that particular equation we define as VL is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4, as such all batteries are connected in series, so then stands for the, but if the batteries are connected in parallel, so here the voltage drop across those batteries are same, so I cannot take the summation of this voltages like I have done in a series connection of this battery. But if you see in this the parallel connection of this battery, where all batteries are connected in parallel, so the current flowing through this parallel connection here, the current flowing through this individual batteries are different, right? But ultimately all these currents are like I1, I2, I3 and I4 are coming at one line, and that defined as IL. So here I can be able to connect one of the load is in parallel with this parallel combination of battery, where the total load current IL, that becomes I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4, since here in a series connection there is a summation of voltage supplies, as well as in a parallel connection there is a summation of the current supply, right? By that way you can learn about the battery and this characteristics, right? Thank you, dear students. If you find any query, please write in a comment box. Thank you very much.